like to share with us the PhD, the ICNT PhD program. What is it? This is a project that we start, the institution start some months ago with different meetings, different proposals from different people involved, from direction, group leaders, human resources, external advisors that we consult. And we have prepared a PhD program that we want to start in the next month. The first idea of the PhD program that we want to share with us is a program to offer to our PhD students different activities in training, monitoring, evaluation. And we want to start with the first call of PhD for PhD application before to the end of this year. Okay. And the first one thing that we want to show is what is a PhD program. It's a structured program, as I said, with our training, evaluation activities, monitoring actions also. And it is done because at the end we have the research. I don't know if there's a what's here. Okay. It's a long-term commitment with the institution, the institute, the ICNT with the PhD students. So why we propose or the institution decides to start this program? Because at the end, having an institutional program, PhD program, we will be more attractive and we can hire the talent, the best talent from our research center. As well, if you offer some activities in training, in monitoring, it's very attractive for the applications, for the applicants. Also because we work with an institutional manner, it's more possible to find good profiles for the applications. And also because at the end, the ICNT is the place where all the PhD students are doing your research. So it's true that we are enrolled with a university, UAB, UPC, UB, but at the end you are doing your PhD here. So it's important that the institution offers to you opportunities, training, and this monitoring in your research career. How we consider that we can do that? So designing an ICNT PhD program, we present this program to the group leaders in the last March in the first HR workshop, and we were discussing with them about the different parts of the program. The first part is the admission. It's important to take care about the admission in this program. Also, all the training activities that are focused for each year of the PhD, and also the monitoring and evaluation activities for each moment in the PhD. Having these three parts detected, we can say that we can have an excellence in the PhD, in all the PhD that are in the ICN2. But also, and not less important, we have different commitments with the HR excellence in research logo or badge that we have. This is a recognition from the European Commission that identifies the center with the best practices and human resources. So we are awarded with that, and we have to follow different action plans that we have defined about training, about career development, so not just in the scientific area, in the scientific knowledge, but also in all the training in transversal skills, soft skills, and different aspects are focused here. And also the Severo Ochoa. As you know, Severo Ochoa have different sections. One of them is the recruitment and training, and there are training plans involved in this project and different activities also in order to help to the research career. This is the framework that we show here that is also generated by the European Commission in order to talk about the different stages in the research career. As you can see, the first one, the R1, is the first stage researcher. This is a category for the point up to the PhD. The researchers that are here, they command that they are different competencies for this situation, for this stage. Necessary competencies and also desirable competencies. It can be a good framework, a good reference for us in order to generate our own competencies program. So it's important for us to have this reference in order to create our own competencies dictionary, for example. And our idea for next year, for example, for the second workshop in HR, is create our own competencies program. Okay. With this classification, the R1, we will have two kinds of first stage researchers in relation to. The first one will be the PhD student. Okay, the PhD student will be included always in the ICNT program, so they have access to the training, to the monitoring, to the evaluation, but also can be some people included as first stage researchers, but not included in a PhD program. So it's important to know this difference. The position name should be defined in the next month, but it's just important to differentiate it. Let's go to talk about the different parts of the program, of the ICNT PhD program. Admission. The admission to the ICNT PhD program will be through an institutional call. The idea is to launch 2 calls per year, okay? So the applicants to the call will be accessed to this PhD program. So we decide and we define to do a recruitment panel to evaluate the different candidates and give the positions to them and the access to the PhD program. Also, there are other possibilities. With a request from the group leader, imagine that one member of the group wants to join to the ICNT PhD program. So there is an option. The group leader can suggest to the panel, the recruitment panel, and they will be evaluated with the same criteria as the institutional call, this student to join to the program. Okay, so this the two difference. Training path. So we have started this year with some activities in training. Some of you have been invited some activities in oral skills, in ethics and research, and writing proposals, and more are forecasting for this year, for example, scientific writing. And we have defined for each year of the career of the PhD different trainings, and the idea is invite you to come and try to do this training. So this research this training path was also created thanks to the collaboration with the group leaders and our different proposals from external also advisors and also with the suggestion of different people. So this is a presentation of the different training activities that we will do in the next month, and the idea is to repeat each year in function of the moment of the PhD student. And the last part is the monitoring and evaluation. There are different types of monitoring and evaluation. The more knowledge is the academic progress. It is done now by the university where you are enrolled. But we want to do something more. And this is a proposal to do different panels in order to obtain the progress as researcher and also the personal progress. We have to define exactly how it will work, but the next month should be done. Okay. So thank you. This is the brief presentation of the program. If you have any question of that, we'll be welcome. Any question? Any comment? No? Okay, so thank you for coming. The room is full, so it's a pleasure for us. So thank you and go to the next part of the activity. Yeah.